When it comes to belts and hoses, what you can't see can't hurt you. While the design and material of belts and hoses have improved over the years, they don't last forever. And when they fail, they don't always leave obvious clues. Take the serpentine belt, for example. When a serpentine belt runs over the surface of a pulley, the friction created between the pulley and the belt results in a gradual loss of material from the belt. Much like a tire loses its tread over time, a serpentine belt wears out over time as material is lost on the rib surface. The rib surface wears to the point that it can no longer effectively and efficiently transmit power. However, modern serpentine belts made of long-lasting EPDM typically don't crack with age like synthetic rubber, so it can be difficult to determine the true condition of a high-mileage belt just by looking at it. So why is that such a big deal? Well, most late-model vehicles use a serpentine belt to help run things like the alternator, power steering, water pump, and air conditioning. So if your customer is relying on visual inspection to make sure the belt is functioning properly, they could be in for an unwelcome surprise that leaves them stranded on the side of the road. Their best bet is to assess the belt at 60,000 miles using a belt wear gauge that checks the depth of the ribbed V-grooves on the underside of the belt. It's also recommended that vehicle owners replace belts and tensioners at 90,000 miles to avoid system failures and to restore the system to its original condition. Now let's talk about hoses. Just like serpentine belts, it's not easy to assess the true condition of a hose just by its outward appearance because hoses tend to fail from the inside out. The coolant hose can be subject to a phenomenon known as electrochemical degradation, or ECD, which attacks the hose from the inside and forms tiny cracks. This can compromise the integrity of the hose, potentially causing the hose to leak or even rupture. And we know that a blown hose can result in an overheated engine and possibly cause additional engine damage. The Car Care Council recommends inspecting hoses at every oil change for leaking, cracks, discoloration, or other signs of wear. Another technique is to squeeze the hose when the engine is cool and replace the hose if it feels rock hard or mushy. But it's just as important to stay true to the service intervals. For example, hoses always should be replaced when a new radiator or water pump is installed, and it's a best practice to replace engine hoses every 90,000 miles to avoid failure or when recommended by an auto care professional. And be sure to recommend a replacement hose that's been designed to resist electrochemical degradation. Because of the vital role that belts and hoses play in the proper functioning of the engine, it's critical to replace these parts before they fail. Following regular inspection and replacement intervals can go a long way toward preventing problems. I'm Josh Cable. Thanks for watching.